Ladies and gentlemen, colleagues, very welcome to this course on neutral sizing. The scope of this course is to analyze technical standard prescription on neutral sizing, to discover some issues that they some problems to be taken into account. We will discuss the theoretical background of this, let's call it, hidden prescription in terms of harmonics and effects of harmonics on neutral current. Then, once the problem will be we will have to approach the sizing criteria. We will provide an example to be sure that everything is clear. And before to conclude, we will list some typical harmonic content. But let's start from the technical standard prescription on neutral sizing. The reference is the IC60364 and specifically part 5, article 524.3. This prescription is fully reproduced in the slide now, and I would suggest to read it together. For polyphase circuits where each phase conductor has a cross-sectional area greater than 16 millimeter square in copper or 25 millimeter square in aluminum, that is a condition. In this condition, the neutral conductor may have a smaller cross-sectional area than the line conductors. Typically, we considered this prescription up to this point. That is the practice for a long time, but still now is for in polyphase circuit when the line conductor are greater than 16 millimeter square, I can reduce the neutral and saving money. But it's important to read this article till the end, and it sounds in this way. This is valid if, just if, the following conditions are simultaneously fulfilled. That is, the first one, the expected maximum current, including harmonics, and this is the main issue for today, if any, in the neutral conductor during normal service is not greater than the current carrying capacity of the reduced cross-sectional area of the neutral conductor. That is, but this is clear, I have to consider the real current flowing into the neutral and not just the theoretical current. Considering this current, obviously, I have to consider also the effect of harmonics. 20 years ago, probably, no, not 10, but 20 years ago, harmonics were something quite rare. Now, harmonics are not the exception, but the most common situation. We have two other conditions to be fulfilled, just to reduce the neutral section. The neutral conductor is protected against overcurrent according to the rules of the same standards, obviously in the right clause. And the last one, the size of the neutral conductor is at least equal to 16 millimeter square in copper or 25 millimeter square in aluminum. Let me repeat. I can reduce the size of the neutral for section greater than 16 millimeter square if these three conditions are simultaneously fulfilled. The most important today, that is the one we will discuss quite deeply, is the one referring to harmonic. I have to check if this condition is fulfilled. To understand the ratio of this prescription, I have to provide a technical background. A technical background on the harmonics and specifically on the effect of harmonics on the harmonics current on the neutral conductor. Let's start from harmonics. Typically for, let's say, 100 years, the conditions to be considered sizing a cable as well as sizing, approaching any other general, let's say general, electrical problem was to refer to a sinusoidal waveform for current as well as for voltage, like this one in our slide. This is still the most common situation in books, and let me say is also the reference situation for a standard prescription. But quite often, like in this case, standard prescription contains also some alert to be taken into account when this condition is not fulfilled. What is the other condition? The other condition is the one in which the voltage or the current, today we are more interested in current distortion instead of voltage distortion. The other situation is this one. The waveform of my current, let's say, is not sinusoidal, but is something different, like this one in the slide. Let me say that this one is created analytically, that is I took Excel and I put some equation to have this waveform. In the reality, I just have a specific waveform. Just in our mind, to represent this situation is quite useful, thanks to Mr. Fourier, to imagine this distorted waveform as the sum of some sinusoidal components, referring to exactly to the previous waveform. I have to consider these two: a fundamental, the red one, and a third harmonic. Let me count. Yes, this is a third harmonic, the violet one. The sum of these two waveform provide exactly the real waveform. And Fourier demonstrated that for any kind of waveform, let's say any kind of distortion, is possible to find a given number of sinusoidal component having a sum equal to the real waveform. Let me say that harmonics does not exist really. It's just an approach quite useful that we can adopt to represent the real waveform. By the way, this is very effective also to face engineering project. So since now I will speak as harmonics would have existed. In reality, I don't have harmonics, but I have a real non-sinusoidal waveform. I don't like distorted. They are real. They are this one. Distorted is something negative. This is just reality, and we cannot think in another way. we have to take into account. But a distorted voltage or current is not necessarily something negative. Indeed, for us, this creates some additional problems. I can represent harmonic components by way of some parameters. The individual harmonic distortion is just the amplitude of a given component referred to the fundamental and expressed in per unit or in percentage, like I did in the slide. Another parameter quite useful to represent with some generality a given waveform is the total harmonic distortion. In such case, I have the average, a quadratic average of each individual harmonic distortion with the equation represented in the last row of my slide, that is this one. Now, today, practically, we are more interested in the first parameter is most useful for our scope. Indeed, the need to manage individual harmonic distortion involve the management of a lot of parameters, or better, more than one, to represent the amplitude of each component, or at least each component of our interest. So these are harmonics, and this is just a trick to represent a waveform that is not sinusoidal, a waveform that we would have expected it was sinusoidal, but it is not. What is the link, what is the effect of this on our neutral current? Let's start considering a balanced linear load, a balanced three-phase linear load, like the one I represented in the slide now. In such a situation, indeed, the current in the neutral is zero. Let me say that when I started to work, or probably also when I was studying, my fundamental question was, how do I have to add a neutral even if the current is zero? Don't worry, I discovered quite soon the reason. By the way, with the balanced linear load, no current into the neutral. And from this, the practice and also the general prescription of the standard to reduce the section of the neutral. Let's consider now an unbalanced linear load. In such case, I have current in the neutral, not zero, but is still less or